Hello everyone, welcome to EduCare 247. This is the 9th lecture of Government Scheme Series. This series is very much useful for RBI, NABARD and SEBI examination. In this series, we are discussing schemes of Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. This is the part 4 of this ministry. You can watch other part in our YouTube channel. NABARD has announced bumper vacancy for NABARD Grade A Officer 2020. EduCare 247 has launched NABARD Grade A Examination 2020 crash course. In this crash course, you will get general awareness, economic and social issues, agriculture and rural development, and computer awareness. All current affairs will be covered in this course: government scheme, economic survey, budget, important reports and indices, report published by different ministries and NABARD, summary of Yojana and Kruchhetra will be covered. You'll get notes, quizzes, and some notes will be in the form of video also. So what are you waiting for? Enroll for this course. The course fee is 2499. You can visit our website educare247.com and subscribe to the courses. We have separate courses for agriculture section also. So if you want only agriculture content, you can subscribe for the same. The first scheme we are discussing here is Mission for Integrated Development of Horticulture. This scheme was implemented in 2014-15. The main aim of this mission is to develop horticulture sector in a holistic manner and integrated manner. It will cover fruits, vegetable, spices, flowers, bamboo, aromatic plants, coconut. So all the sector will be covered under this scheme. The government of India will contribute 85% of total outlay for developmental programs for all the state except Northeast and Himalayan region state. For these states, Government of India will contribute 100% of the budget. National Mission on Horticulture has been allocated 2200 crore in Union Budget 2019-20. This figure can be important for your upcoming examination. Let's discuss the objective of Mission for Integrated Development of Horticulture. The first objective is promote holistic growth of horticulture sector including bamboo and coconut through area-based regionally differentiated strategies, because for each state the strategies will be different. And what kind of strategy will be adopting? Research, technology promotion, post-harvest management, processing and marketing. It will encourage aggregation of farmers into farmer group like farmer producing organization. So it will form a group to improve the horticulture sector. It will enhance horticulture production, augment farmer incomes and strengthen nutritional security. It will improve productivity by way of quality improvement, planting material and water use efficiency through micro irrigation. It will also support skill development and create employment generation opportunities for rural youth in horticulture sector and post-harvest management. So it will holistically develop the sector. That is the overall objective of this mission. Let's see some sub-scheme and areas of operation for this mission. The first sub-mission is National Horticulture Mission. The aim of this mission is to promote holistic growth of horticulture sector through an area-based, regionally differentiated strategy. The second important sub-schemes is Horticulture Mission for Northeast and Himalayan State. So in these states, horticulture sector will be developed. The another sub-scheme is National Horticulture Board. It is implementing various schemes of this overall mission. The another sub-scheme is Coconut Development Board. It helps implementing various schemes, especially in all coconut growing states. The another sub-scheme is National Institute for Horticulture, Nagaland. It is providing technical back support for this mission. So these are the important sub-scheme of this mission. Let's discuss some important strategies and action plan under this mission. It will adopt end-to-end approach with backward and forward linkages. So from input to supply chain will be linked. It will promote R&D technologies for cultivation and other activities with a special focus on cold chain infrastructure. It will improve productivity through diversification of crops, extension of technologies and increasing acreage and orchards. It will improve post-harvest management, value addition processing and marketing infrastructure. It will promote FPOs and their links with market aggregators and financial institutions. In 2014, Project Chaman was launched, which envisages use of satellite remote sensing data along with geographical information system for generating action plan for horticulture sector. So you can remember, Project Chaman is related to use of satellite data for horticulture development. This can be asked. This is very, very important point. Let's discuss what kind of financial assistance will be provided under this scheme. For setting up nurseries, tissue culture units for production of quality seeds and planting material, the finance will be provided. For establishment of new orchards, garden of fruits, vegetables and flowers, for rejuvenation of unproductive old and senile orchards, for poly houses, greenhouses to improve the productivity and grow of season's high value vegetables and flowers, for organic farming and certification, for creation of water resources, infrastructure and watershed management, beekeeping for pollination, horticulture mechanization, creation of post-harvest management and marketing infrastructure. For all these activities, finances will be provided under this scheme. Our next scheme is National Project on Soil Health and Fertility. It aimed at promoting location as well as crop-specific sustainable soil health management. It will include residue management, organic farming practices and creating map for macro and micronutrient management. It will provide specific information about the land and soil type also. It has provision for setting up new soil testing laboratories, mobile soil testing laboratories, fertilizer quality control laboratories and their strengthening for paving the way for judicious use of chemical fertilizer. It also includes provision for soil health card, which will provide information for soil nutrient status, especially for the macro and micronutrients, what kind of fertilizer use will be there, that information will be given. In budget 2019-20, 325 crore had been allocated for this national project. So you can remember, this is very, very important project. Under this, that soil health card is the most important part. We'll discuss this part in detail. Let's discuss soil health card scheme. This scheme was launched by Government of India in February 2015. Under this scheme, government plans to issue soil cards to farmers, which will carry crop-wise recommendation of nutrients and fertilizer required for individual farms. It will help farmers to improve productivity and judicious use of inputs. All soil samples are tested in various soil testing labs across the country, and it will analyze the soil sample and give the recommendation for different nutrients. So this is very useful scheme. It will reduce the input cost of the farmer. The government plans to issue the card to 14 crore farmers. So you can remember the number also. The objective of this scheme is to issue soil health card after every 3 years to all farmers of the country, so as to provide a basis to address nutrient deficiencies in fertilizer practices. It will strengthening functioning of soil testing laboratories through capacity building, improvement of the lab, student and effective linkage of Indian Council of Agricultural Research and State Agricultural Universities. So the testing lab will be integrated with the Indian Council of Agricultural Research. So quality of this lab will be improved. Let's discuss some of the salient features of soil health card scheme. It is being implemented through Department of Agriculture of all state and union territory governments. Assistance is provided to state government to issue soil health card in developing a database to improve services delivery. This card will carry crop wise recommendation of nutrient and fertilizer required for individual farms. The expert will analyze the strength and weakness of the soil collected from farms and suggest measure to deal with it. It will give information about macronutrient, secondary nutrient and micronutrient. You can remember name of these nutrient. It will provide information about pH also. According to soil health card, fertilizer recommendation will be given. So this is the overall features of this scheme. Hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have enjoyed the video, like, share and comment. Thank you and happy learning.